respect this pimpin' hooker. Me and my niggas done had it up to here with you fucking turf bugs. Therefore we will express ourselves. Fuck you bitches in 2001. You wrong kind affiliated, so we do things in the wrong manner. Check it out,
what's up? You know that.
Who?
Bitch.
What bitch?
Only like two types of niggas.
What type?
And that's Bloods and Crips.
Is that right?
Punk ass bitch.
Yeah, I know her. Used to rep this.
I made my first song in like what? I think it was 97. And my homies basically had some shit going. They had Bottom Up Records. I don't know if you know Bottom Up Records, but they had Don Moo on it later when they had one of my homies from my neighborhood, Baby Line down. Y'all probably know him now as Don Diego. But they was doing some stuff over there and we was just fucking around, you know what I'm saying? But I started seeing something real happening. My folks are spending real bread. They spent like 50 racks and went toward the Gavin up in the Bay Area. And I just was enthused by, you know, seeing my homies coming together about something that can make some dope. So I got in, you know. Made my first demo with Cat. I ain't gonna say his name. We just showed the other ways that he's a bitch. But anyway, I made my first demo, shopped it around. A month after I made the demo, doing cool in the streets. I had a couple cuts on there. It was doing real cool in the streets. A few homies heard it. My boy, Black Reese, y'all probably know Reese, he do an exhibit all the time. He had just got out the pen and he was dealing with DJ Jam, which is Snoop Dogg's DJ, which is from San Diego, one of the homies. He was fucking with Sir Jinx, you know. Ice Cube producer at the time, Dr. Dre first cousin, produced America's Most Wanted, Dub C, Mad Circle and all that shit. Reese took me directly up to Jinx. Jam said, man, I know Jinx, he doing something. We went there, I hollered at DJ Jam. Me and Jam came up with the idea to go holler at Jinx through Reese. I just started working on my first little real songs with Jinx. I was like 98. From there, we went to, It was everything. I went overnight. I never gave a fuck about rap, you know what I'm saying? Overnight, I'm fucking with Dub C and meeting DJ Pooh and fucking Exhibit and all these cats just overnight. It was like, damn, I was like, damn, this shit can't be that hard, you know what I'm saying? So I just started pushing from that point right there, you know? I got my first release was Triggeration Station. Actually, my first release was some little underground shit me and my little homie Lil Fatal did, but it didn't go as far as I wanted to because of some little stipulations through probation and all that type of shit or whatever. But my first release, I released it on Southwest, I mean on fucking, fuck that bullshit ass distribution company, homie. Select those bullshit hits. And I put my first record out through them. Matter of fact, I ain't even gonna diss Select them like that. All I'm gonna say is, just to clear it up, because you know this type of shit go a long way. They didn't do what they should have done. What they should have done, and I guess everybody feel that, you know, their company should really back them or whatever, even though I was a new artist. I know that if they knew that I was gonna make the noise on the underground level the way that I did, they probably would have made better moves, but they didn't believe in me, so they just let my shit sit up on the shelf and rock. But you know, Selecto Hits was the first distributor I had that was Triggeration Station, my first album. Triggeration Station, I charted 13 on Billboard the first week out. Along with the Eastsiders and a couple other cool albums, Lil Jon and this shit. That was like 201, building up 202. Second releases after that was just mixtape shit. Y'all can go get that Double XL Guns. I said the streets right now today, we're making the most ones right now. So other than that, you know, just get featured and shit. I got a record coming out right now with a new group I got. Actually, it's Exhibit's group. With my homie Prime Don and Phil the Ad. You know, it's next level shit, you know what I'm saying, as far as the type of music we making and the type of, you know what I'm saying, people that we appealing to, you know. But, you know, that strong arm steady game. It's official, you know, new shit.